In this example, we are given that a heavy but uniform rope of length L is suspended from the ceiling. It is saying the rope is given a jerk at its bottom end. We are required to find the velocity of pulse created by the jerk as a function of distance x from the bottom end x. Also find the time taken by the pulse to reach the top. So, in this situation, we know that wave velocity at any point in a string can be given as root of T by mu, where mu is the linear mass density. And if we take the mass of this rope to be m, its mu can be written as m by L, as length is given as L. Now, in this situation, at a distance x from the bottom end, if we wish to find out the wave velocity, we need to find out the tension in the string, which is acting on the lower part in upward direction and in the upper part in downward direction. So, this tension will be due to the weight of this lower part of the string. So, we can write tension in a string at a distance x from bottom is, this can be calculated as the weight of the lower part, which can be written as m by L into x into g. If for length L mass is m, mass per unit length will be m by L, and the mass of this length x can be written as m by L x, and its weight will be m by L x g. So, in this situation, if we find out the wave speed at point P, this wave speed can be simply written as root of T by mu. It is m by L x g divided by m by L. So, this can be simply written as root x g, which will be the answer to this problem. And as the speed is root xg, we are also required to find the time taken by the pulse to reach the top. This v we can write as dx by dt, which is written as root of xg. So, here we can write dx by root x is equals to root g dt. If we integrate it at t equal to 0, x was 0, and at a time t, the pulse reaching the topmost point of the string up to L. Then on integrating this, we'll directly get integration of 1 by root x will be 2 root x, will apply limits from 0 to L, and it will be root g into t, limits will be from 0 to t. On simplifying, here we'll get 2 root L is equals to root g t. So, we can directly see the time taken by the pulse to reach the top can be written as 2 root of L by G. That will be the answer to the second part of this problem.